FTTA OTDR is an option available for OTDR modules installed on Viavi's T-Bird and MTS family of test sets. It provides simple, dedicated setup menus for fiber to the antenna testing and labels FTTA network elements on the fiber link. It addresses the needs of construction crews installing cable on a tower, as well as service providers or contractors turning up and troubleshooting fiber to the antenna. During construction, FTTA OTDR is used to test the cable pairs between the remote radio unit at the top of the tower and the baseband unit at the bottom of the tower. The link will include a short jumper cable and junction box at the top of the tower connected to the trunk table. Some tower architectures include a junction box and patch cable at the bottom of the tower. In other tower architectures, the trunk cable is directly connected to the BBU. A loopback jumper and coupler is used at the top of the tower to connect uplink and downlink fibers so that both fibers can be tested concurrently. The OTDR is connected to either fiber in the trunk cable or BBU jumper via a 20-meter launch cable and optical coupler. A 20-meter receive cable can optionally be connected to the other fiber to measure loss through that connector. I will now demonstrate how to use the FTTA OTDR option in construction mode on a tower architecture without a BBU jumper or junction box at the bottom of the tower. If you're not at a tower, you can follow along on your T-Bird or MTS with a 20-meter launch cable plus five additional simplex patch cables interconnected with optical couplers to simulate the tower architecture. All fibers should be clean and pass fiber inspection tests before connection. Once connected, we just have to load a configuration file, tweak a few settings, and we'll be ready to test. So here we go. After turning on the test set and connecting to the fiber under test, tap the fiber optics icon and the home icon to display the OTDR's home screen. Tap the FTTA OTDR or fiber to the antenna icon to launch the test. Then press the setup button to configure your test settings. In the acquisition menu, tap load config and select the FTTA RRU construction loop single mode OTDR configuration file. Then tap load as FTTA config. Set your laser to all or 1310 and 1550 to enable bend detection. The top menu soft key at the bottom of the screen returns us to the main settings menu where we can navigate to other settings. Under alarms, you can tweak the alarm thresholds for connector loss and reflectance. By default, connector loss must be under a half a dB, reflectance must be under 45 dB, and total link loss must be under 6 dB for the test to pass. In analysis settings, I'm going to set BBU jumper to no to reflect my tower architecture. I did not have a distribution box and BBU jumper at the bottom of the tower. If your tower architecture includes a distribution box and jumper, set the value to yes. I did not have a receive cable, so I will set receive cable start to no also. Note that loopback cable is set to yes in this configuration. I'm going to leave link settings at their defaults except for distance unit, which I'm going to change to feet. When you're in the field, you should specify the base station ID because this will determine your file names. The fiber number will auto increment by default. I will leave file settings at defaults to auto store results to the fiber directory. Note that the file name will include the base station ID and fiber code as configured in the prior menu. I'll press start stop to initiate the test. The OTDR will perform a connection test and then perform acquisitions on both wavelengths. After a few seconds, test results are shown in both graphical and tabular formats. The graph shows the reflected signal level across the length of the fiber. I can tell all my connections are clean because all the spikes are about the same level. The end of the fiber has a very high reflection because it's not connected to anything. Between the spikes, I see my launch cable, trunk cable, an RRU jumper going up the tower, the loopback cable, the RRU jumper, and the trunk cable coming down the tower. The table lists each event and is color-coded red or green to indicate alarm status for each event in the trace. All of my loss and reflectance values are good. My link ORL and total loss also pass my default alarm settings. Smart Link View provides a simpler means of assessing these results. All of the events are shown as icons. The link table shows overall results for each wavelength tested. If I switch to event view, the connectors are labeled and I can see results for individual events. Bottom tower is the connection between my launch cable and the trunk cable at the bottom of the tower. Top tower is the connection between the trunk cable and the RRU jumper at the top of the tower. That's followed by the loopback, connected to my RRU jumper at the top of the tower, connected to the trunk cable coming down the tower, and finally the end of the fiber span under test. The length of each cable is shown between the events. I can click on any icon to see the results for that event. That concludes my demonstration of FTTA OTDR in construction mode. During turnup and maintenance, FTTA OTDR is also used to test the cable pairs between the remote radio unit at the top of the tower and baseband unit at the bottom of the tower. However, only one fiber can be tested at a time since you cannot install a loopback without a tower crew. The OTDR is connected to either fiber in the trunk cable or BBU jumper at the bottom of the tower via a 20-meter launch cable and optical coupler. If the fiber is lit, a filtered OTDR is needed to test at 1625 nanometers or 1650 nanometers. If you're not at a tower, you can follow along with my demonstration with a launch cable plus three additional patch cables interconnected with optical couplers. As always, all fibers should be clean and pass fiber inspection tests before connection. I have already launched the FTTA OTDR test, so I'll just press the setup button to configure test settings. In the acquisition menu, I'll tap Load Config, and this time I'll select the FTTA RRU Maintenance Single Mode OTDR configuration. I'll set laser to 1310 and 1550 to enable bend detection, and I'll leave alarms at defaults. In analysis settings, I'll define the tower architecture. I am using a launch cable, the end of which will be my first event, and I have distribution boxes at both the bottom of the tower and the top of the tower. If your tower architecture lacks a distribution box at the bottom of the tower, set BBU jumper to no. In link settings, as well as file settings, I will leave everything at defaults. I'm ready to test, so I'll tap Start Stop. The OTDR will trace both fibers on both wavelengths. Back in trace view, I can see the spikes for my four connectors and the end of the fiber. And between the spikes, I see my launch cable, BBU jumper, trunk cable, and RRU jumper. In the table, each event is color-coded green. All of my loss and reflectance values are good, as well as my link ORL and total loss. In Smart Link view, I see a simplified view of the trace as a series of icons. If I tap Event View, the connectors are labeled and I can see results for individual events. BBU is the connector between my launch cable and the BBU jumper. Bottom tower is the connection in the distribution box at the bottom of the tower. Top tower is the connection in the distribution box at the top of the tower. And RRU is the fiber end face connected to the RRU. The length of each cable is shown between events. Per setup, the trace files have been automatically named and saved to the results folder. I can press the File button to browse stored files or to copy and paste them to a USB flash drive. That concludes my demonstration of the FTTA OTDR option.